So let us start today's class. And today we are speaking about the next program, which is to convert kilometers into meters and centimeters. So we are supposed to write a C program to convert kilometers into meters and centimeters. For that, we need a formula. We should know 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters and 1 kilometer is equal to 100,000 centimeters. So next, how do you do that? First, we have to start how to see. The flowchart is very, very important. The flowchart will tell us how, what are the inputs you are taking, how it is computation is done, and then how the results are outputted. Now, when we start the program, we should take some input parameters, values from the user. So we are taking the distance, that in kilometer. The moment you take the result, this input from the user in kilometers, it will be computed. How do you compute? The value, whatever you are taking, that you are storing in this variable, that should be multiplied by 1000. And it should be saved back to one more parameter, one more variable called distance. Okay, the distance, that is the name of the variable, UL meters I'm using here. Okay, then the same whatever the value has entered, kilometers, that should be multiplied by 100,000. And again, it should be saved back to the variable UL centimeters. Then you have to print the meters as well as centimeters value, which is stored, which is being stored in variable. So you end the process. This is what the procedure or flow of a program. So we need only one header file here. That is, you are using a printf and scanf. That's why stdio.h. You're starting from the main function. You're calling main function first. That's why the name is given as main, because the main program will be called by the OS. This main function will be called by the OS first initially. Nobody can call other than OS. You're creating three variables. The variable by name, UL kilometers, UL meters, and UL centimeters. Unsigned long. UL means unsigned long. Unsigned long. So value for meters and centimeters, you are declaring it as zero. So now the value should be read to the input data from the user. So we are asking, you are supposed to give the information to the user to enter the length. That's why you are supposed to use printf. Using printf function, you have to tell, enter the length. When he enters, you should be very, very, it should be very informative. That's why you have to write in kilometers in bracket, I have written. So take, you are asking the user to enter the length. You are, whatever the user will enter, that will be read to the variable this. So how do you read that? Using scanf function. What is the syntax for scanf function? What is the syntax? The scanf function contains two parameters as an argument. The first one is type of the variable and ampersand followed by variable name. Now you're supposed to apply the formula to convert into meters and centimeters. So kilometers, the value is stored already. Whatever the user has entered, he has saved in this kilometers. That should be multiplied by 1000 and it will be stored in UL meters. Okay. Again, because here using printf, you have asked and you have read the value, whatever user has entered is stored in this variable. That stored value should be multiplied by 1000 and it should be set back or should be stored back to the one more variable, meters. Okay, unsigned long meters. Similarly, this also, the same value should be multiplied by this value and it should be saved back to unsigned long centimeters. Now you are supposed to display the result. First, I will prompt, I will give the information to the user saying that this is what the value of kilometer and meters you entered. That's why I'm printing those. This is optional. If you want, you can print, otherwise you can. Because you are printing, again I'm printing here your kilometers and centimeters. See, this is unsigned, this is whatever the value using printer. What you want, what you're supposed to print, that you can write it in this printer function. Now, first I'll print kilometer and meter value. Next, immediately using one more printer statement, I will print kilometer as well as centimeters. Slash n is new line character. It will go to the next line. Okay. How the program output will be displayed? First, you are entering the length in kilometers. If suppose user has entered 35 kilometer, then that how it will print, how the output will be printed. See, you can directly print 35,000 meters. Okay, but it will be informative if you are written, if it is displayed like this. 35 kilometers is equal to 35,000 meters. 35 kilometers is equal to 350,000 meters. 3500 centimeters. What are the things you're supposed to, after learning this program, what you are supposed to, what you can change or modify, what extra you can do? You should add the logic to validate the input. If user inputs a negative value, then you have to show the appropriate error message. Okay? Because you're not supposed to take a negative value as an input, you should tell the user to give or enter the proper input value. So today we have done the conversion kilometers to centimeters as well as kilometers to meters. So you can, if you have any queries regarding this program, you can write to the mail ID which I have displayed here. And also you can subscribe to our channel and it is displayed on the screen. For any queries, you can reach me. Thanks for watching.